This dream has been on my sights for almost 4 years now.
With as many medals as Mike Schultz has won, you'd think he was born on a snowboard.
It was a steep learning curve because I didn't learn snowboarding until after I became an amputee.
In 2008, the professional motocross and snowcross racer suffered a severe injury after he was thrown from his snowmobile.
At no point did I think I was going to lose my leg over it. I knew it was bad, extremely bad, but after a couple days in the hospital, after surgery, and we realized that kind of the only option for me to move forward was to amputate my leg. It was a very tough time for my wife and I, and we'd been married for a year.
A new normal. And if you know Mike, you know that just wasn't going to do.
I set out to build my own leg. I call it the Moto Knee. It uses a mountain bike shock in it.
Yep, Mike built his own leg and foot and started racing again.
I went to X Games 7 months after my injury on a leg that I developed in my garage, and I won a silver medal. And that moment there was so powerful. There was so much stuff that had to happen for me to get there.
As the medals stacked up, Mike noticed something. The other athletes didn't have the same kind of equipment. So he started a company called BioDapt, making legs and feet for his competitors.
And the feedback that I get when I'm working with an amputee who tries it for the first time and then just has that moment where he's like, I can ride again, and I can ride well. Just seeing that excitement and happiness is priceless. It's just so motivating for me and rewarding. And you know, that to me is worth more than winning medals.
But competitive nature called, and so did the USA Paralympic snowboarding team. So Mike got on a board just 4 years ago. Now, there have been ups and downs, but let's just say he's peaking at just the right time.
I ended up winning both championships in the border cross and bank slalom, ranked number one in the world for both of those. So yeah, this year's going good.
He plans to ride that success right into the Winter Games. What about all those other athletes from around the world using the equipment that he developed? Mike Schultz isn't too worried.
I really enjoy helping these other athletes and try to give them the tools to perform the best they possibly can. And then I'm competing against them. So that's kind of a catch-22 there. It's like, do I want to give them all my secrets? I'm like, no. No, I always got a little secret of my own on my own equipment.
I don't want to jinx anything.
It's kind of like your rector said.
Let's just say a guy whose name rhymes with, I don't know, Bike Bolts is an odds-on favorite to stand on the podium more than once.
My goal is to get there and perform, be focused 100%, and be able to put down my best race runs up to this point. If I do that, the medals are going to come. If I come home without a medal, no, I'm not going to be satisfied at all. I might have to do this whole journey for another 4 years. I don't know.
Okay, let's just take it one race at a time. And if having a cool nickname helps.
Yeah, you know, my real nickname has always been Monster, but this year, you know, the red, white, and blue leg, my team calls me Captain America, so I'll take it.
Go get him, Captain America. The whole state of Minnesota will be cheering.
That's the truth. Here's some exciting news. Schultz's teammates picked him to carry the American flag at the opening ceremony. It will air live at 5 a.m. tomorrow on NBCSN. And his first race, by the way, is Sunday night. We'll be sure to keep you updated.
Pretty cool.
Oh, what a cool guy.
Very
I love it.
I love that. I mean, that that drive and that. And also
innovation.
Just, yeah, and happiness. That's fantastic. Yeah. Amazing. So we have a ski report. How about that? Snowboard report.
Let's
just
do it.
For him. Yes, we do. You know what? The ski resorts, and of course, you know, I talk about this every Thursday night, but they really do still have some phenomenal snowpack. And of course, the Mother